press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hi students, under triangles inequality we were solving problems in exercise 7.4. so far we have completed 4 questions in exercise 7.4. so now I will take up question number 5. so exercise 7.4 question number 5. So here a diagram is given. I will first draw the diagram. This is so PQR is the given triangle and PS is the angular bisector. So what is given? Given PR greater than PQ. So given triangle PQR where PR greater than PQ. So PR is larger angle, PQ is smaller angle. So that is given. PS bisects QPR. So PS bisects QPR. So to prove what is to be proved? To prove PSR is greater than angle PSQ. So this we have to prove. So we should show that this is bigger angle and this is smaller angle. Now observe here, proof. Given PS bisects angle PQR. So this dotted line bisects these two angles. Bisects mean these two angles are equal. So therefore QPS is equal to QPS is equal to RPS. Observe it. RPS. So these two angles are equal. Now PR is greater than PQ. In the triangle PQR, PR is bigger angle. So I will call this as 1. So here, because PR is bigger, this PQR or PQS, this angle is bigger than this angle, because PR is bigger 1, it is given PR is greater 1. So therefore I will write PQS is greater than, I will write greater than PQ opposite is R, therefore PRQ or PRS, they are one and the same. So PRS. So Q is angle, this is bigger angle and this is smaller angle. You call this equation as 2. QPS. Now you add these two equations. So add 1 plus 2, add 1 plus 2. If you add these two equations, you will get QPS. So I will write here QPS, left hand side, and plus PSQ is greater than. See, in one equation we have equals, in one another equation we have greater than. So therefore we have to take greater than. So how it is, I will show you. If say 8 equals 8 is one equation, and say 11 is greater than 7, let us say. This is first equation, this is second equation. If you add these two, 8 plus 11 is 19, 19 is greater than 8 plus 7, 15. So therefore we have to take the greater sign. So therefore RPS is plus PRS, RPS plus PRS. Now you observe these things. QPS is this angle, PSQ is this angle. So these are with respect to, you observe here, these total of these two, these are in the triangle PQS and extended R. These are compared to this angle, these are interior opposite angles, their sum will be equal to PSR. The sum of these two interior angles is same as PSR. Therefore, left hand side I will write PSR greater than. PSR greater than RPS. RPS, you observe here, RPS is this angle and PRS is this angle. So if you add these two, you will get the exterior angle PSQ, this angle. So I will write PSQ. So PSR greater than PSQ. That is what we have proved. So reason I will write for this, from here to here, how we got the sum of interior opposite angles is equal to equal to exterior angle. Exterior angle. So on the basis of this, we have written this. That means here exterior angle is PSR is exterior, therefore it is equal to this angle plus this angle. This is what is this. And if you consider PSR triangle, this angle is exterior, that is PSQ is exterior. So therefore the sum of addition of these two will be PSQ. So therefore RPS plus PRS is equal to PSQ. So hence proved. So this completes question number 5. So question number 6 and the final question in exercise 7.4. So question is like this: show that of all line segments, drawn from a given point on, not on it, the perpendicular line segment is shortest. So try to understand this question. So line segment, so we have to have a line segment. Let this be a line segment L, let us say. This is line L. Consider any point on it. Which is not on it. So L is a line. Consider any point which is not on the line, and if you draw so many line segments to touch this line, the one which is perpendicular to the line will be the shortest distance. So that is the meaning of this question. So now let this point is under consideration. So this is one line, this is another line, let us say. So we call this as point A, point B, point C. So if it is perpendicular, so then what is to be proved is, see here the question is simple. L is a line. You take any point outside the line, on either side of course. So A is any point which is not on line L. So we have drawn two line segments here. AC is one line segment. AB is another line segment, where AB is perpendicular to the line L and AC is not perpendicular. Now our problem is we have to prove that AB is the smallest. So that means AB is less than AC. AB is less than AC. So that is what is to be proved. So given line L, you can say line L P be any point not on that line, so it is outside that line. So then AB perpendicular to line L, AB perpendicular to line L, it is also given. To prove AB less than AC, any line, so not necessarily AC here only, you can be like this, it can be another line, it can be another line, you can draw any number of lines, but the shortest length is one which is perpendicular to L, so that is the meaning. So now proof in triangle ABC, angle B is equal to 90 degree, angle B is equal to 90 degree. Also angle A plus B plus C is equal to 180 degree. So therefore A plus C is equal to 180 minus 90 equals 90 degree. Sum of A and C is 90 degree. Sum of A and C is 90 degree. Therefore, angle C must be acute angle. So, in any right angle triangle, one angle is 90 degree, another two are acute angles. Acute angle. So, when A and C are acute angle, C is always less than B. So therefore angle C is less than angle B, because angle B is 90 degree. Angle B is 90 degree. So C is smaller, B is bigger. So we have proved that C angle is smaller, B angle is bigger. C is less than B. So therefore the side opposite to C, that is AB. So therefore AB must be less than side opposite to B, that is AC. So why this is? This is based on inequality theorem. So because side opposite to, here we have taken smaller angle. Smaller angle will be smaller in length. So hence proved. hence proved. So dear students, with this we have completed so all the topics which are included in your textbook, including all exercise problems. So now I will take up few minutes just to recall what you have learned in this chapter, triangles. Just I will recall your knowledge, and with that I am going to conclude this chapter. I hope you have learnt. If you still have got any doubts, you may please post your queries, so I will try to answer your and clarify your doubts. So in triangles we have discussed mainly the theories. We did some revision in similarity, and we dealt about congruency of triangles. So you know that the two squares, let us say, two squares with different side length, when the side length is different, we say they are similar. So one may be say 2 by 2 units, this is a square, this is 2 centimeter 2 centimeter 2 centimeter 2 centimeter. So another may be say 5 units, it is a square with say 5 5 5 5. So both are square, but the dimension is differs, therefore they are similar. So similarly, if two squares with same side length are there, same side length, two squares with same side length, or we say congruent. So that means if you have two squares with say 3 3 3 3, another with 3 3 3 3 side 3 units 3 units 3 units, both are square, then they are congruent. Two circles with different radius are similar. Two circles with the same radius are congruent. So similarly in triangles, so we have dealt about congruency of triangles. There we have learnt about side angle congruency. This we have learnt, and we call this as SAS congruence. And we have learnt about ASA, one side and two opposite angles. And we have discussed about two angles and a side, because the third angle will be automatically equal. This is also a valid congruence rule. So then we have the SSS congruence, then we have the RHS congruence. So these are the triangle congruence rule we have learned and understood. So you have to remember these things. So, and after this we have understood the inequality rule. There the three important things you have to remember: in any triangle, the sum of two sides will always be greater than the length of the third side. That is one. And in a triangle, the largest side opposite angle will be larger, and the smallest angle opposite side will be smaller. So this is the gist you have to remember in this chapter. So shortly I will give you some more problems in triangles. So I have sent some homework problems. Try to solve those problems. So if you find any difficulty, you are always welcome to put queries and get clarification from me. So thank you all. Thank you, students.